Who is determined enough to kill every monster in RuneScape to show off the drops? Who is crazy enough to do a 100-hour livestream? Mr. No Sleep. Mr. No Sleep is a content creator with close to 160,000 subscribers, with over 30 million views. Today, we are taking a rare inside look into how Mr. No Sleep got into content creation, any health repercussions from his long streams, his 100-hour livestream, and how long he slept after that stream. If you don't know who Mr. No Sleep is, all of his socials will be down in the description, make sure to check him out. There is a lot of information in this video you may not know about Mr. No Sleep, so make sure to watch till the end. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that subscribe button if you're new here, and let's get right into the interview. The first question I wanted to ask Mr. No Sleep is how long he started playing RuneScape and what made him get into it.
For me, I started in 2005. I got into it because my older brother of 2 years, he got into it first. And he was always on it. And I never really used the computer at this point. I was still pretty young. And he introduced me to it. And I got addicted. And he quit maybe 3 years after. And I never did, so.
Since Mr. No Sleep has been playing since 2005, I wanted to know what made him start creating content.
That's a great question. Honestly, just inspiration from others. You know, most of my childhood, I'd much rather watch YouTube videos than, you know, cable or TV. I started that pretty young, and I see that that's mostly what people do nowadays, you know. So I was, you know, really entertained in 2008, you know, to 2011. I think that was prime time for RuneScape video makers, and even before then, and watching those videos, you know, whether it was commentary, whether it was just music and, you know, PKing, PvP, that's inspiration enough. You know, certainly never thought it would become a job one day, but for many, many years, it was just a really, really fun hobby.
Since YouTube as a job is usually like plan B or plan C, I want to know what he would be doing if he did not have a career in content creation.
The original plan for me was when I was 17, I was looking to join the military, as soon as I graduated high school the following year. I did up until I got to MEPS, and then that's kind of like where you decide, you know, sign the contract for 3 years or not. And I don't know, I decided, you know, right out of high school, maybe committing to something for so long wouldn't be the greatest idea. So I wanted to take a year to decide what I wanted to do. And it was at that year that a lot of things were interesting, you know, going to college full time or, pursuing a job in something specific or just doing the military thing. But for me overall, as it goes for if this wasn't ever a possibility, I probably would have done the military route for a few years and then they would have paid for college. And then I would have probably got a degree in maybe history, pursued, you know, teaching, education, something in front of, you know, people and maybe not a lot of people. So I think teaching would be cool, you know, be a high school teacher, something like that. And I was always really fond of my teachers, you know, growing up, they were always great role models. So probably something along the lines of that.
Since Mr. No Sleep has done over 200 loot videos, I want to know which loot video was his favorite.
It varies, you know, if you ask me on, you know, if I'm on a live stream, you ask me on one day, you might get a different answer than you would a week from then. But most of the time I answer, I just say loot from 1,000 rune golems. It's a very, very weird monster. It's in deep wilderness. And really the point of that video was to show that, you know, even if you're killing something in the wild, you can always fight back if you get attacked by other players. So not only do you get, you know, kind of a mysterious monster, but you also get a lot of PvP content in that video. And it was released just around Christmas Day a couple years ago. And yeah, it was just a great time in my channel. It's probably the peak of my channel at that point. So that'd probably be my favorite video for many different reasons.
Mr. No Sleep's early videos is him skilling or killing a boss for 30 hours straight. I want to know why he started that as a start to his channel.
Amazing. No one's ever asked that before. So there used to be this website. It's not that popular anymore. It's called CrystalMathLabs.com. Basically, it's an XP tracking website, you know, and when old school RuneScape first came out, the high scores was very competitive. And what people used to do on this website was they would sit and play RuneScape for not 24 hours straight, but for 30 hours straight. The concept of this was to get as much experience as you could in one specific skill. So there'd be records, you know, who can get the most experience in agility in one sitting in 30 hours with no sleep, minimal bathroom breaks, no showers, nothing like that. And I thought this concept was fascinating. And my name at the time wasn't even Mr. No Sleep. The name originated from something completely different. And I thought, well, my YouTube channel is only getting about, 500 views to 1,000 views a video. Let me try this idea. Let me train agility for 30 hours straight. Let me record it and see how it does. I was getting close to 99, so I recorded it, very unprofessional, but at the same time, it was still 30 hours. I still proved that it was. And once I uploaded that video, just as a sheer gamble, just as a, it seemed like a great idea, and it broke 10,000 views in a week. And at that point, I thought, Jesus, this could be the future. And so I tried out, monsters shortly after that. The next one was 30 hours of killing skeletal wyverns. And it was that video that broke 100,000 views for me in very less than a month on using Hypercam 2, horrible quality mic, and it still worked. So I said to myself, sleep deprivation is going to be the one thing that can get my channel views. Why not stick with it? And then it just became a full-time thing. And the hours went from 24 to 30 to 40 to 50 to 60. And then we did a 100 hour.
I know a lot of small content creators watch my channel. I want to know what advice you would give to new and aspiring content creators.
Patience is key. If you want to do it for a full-time job, you have to expect to make nothing for a long time. You can't have high expectations, especially on YouTube, especially on Twitch, because it is so hard to get your name out there. It is so hard to, come up with a unique idea that someone hasn't done before, but it can be done. I think there's always room for more streamers. I think there's always room for more YouTubers. And I think the creativity just in the past 3 years alone has shown that the bar has been risen so much for what good quality content is. So if you're going to do it, take it seriously. You have to have it, as almost as a mindset, take it very seriously and don't give up. Just be patient. But if you want to do it as a part-time job and just have fun with it, just be yourself. Try not to, act like someone you're not. Try not to do things that you originally wouldn't do. Peer pressure is a real thing, even online. So just follow what you enjoy. And chances are, if you enjoy it, even if it's a small amount of people that watch it rather than a big amount, because it does take time for that, you'll still start a small community.
Definitely great advice from Mr. No Sleep. Most of his viewers nowadays do not remember Mr. No Sleep's first channel. It was still named Mr. No Sleep and it had about 5,000 subscribers. So what happened to that channel?
So that channel was originally my first ever old school RuneScape channel. And not many people remember this. And I doubt even people who would hear this even remember. But there used to be a long time ago, there was a girl streamer who only did one stream. Her name was, I think, Felicia. Basically, something went down in this live stream, caused a little drama in the community. And on this one specific YouTube channel, I made a video of it. I just covered it. It was just a live stream, not like a drama alert type of thing. I was just kind of discussing the situation that occurred. And this was at the very start of old school. So I did that. I uploaded the videos, just a simple 10-minute video about me talking about it. And this blew up. It got 300,000 views. And my channel went from, I think 500 subscribers to, like you said, I think it peaked around 5K. And then the views, went from 100 to 1,000. But unfortunately, even having over 100 videos at this point, which all had minimal views, except this one specific video that I had uploaded, I had a lot of music in them. And all of this music was copyrighted. And it was one specific day where all of my videos, almost all of them, got deleted without any permission, without any approval. You put copyright music in your videos, you're going to pay the price. And at this point, I was young, I was dumb, and I certainly didn't think I'd make anything from it. But this one viral video that I did on this one Twitch stream did make me money. That was the first ever time I had made a couple hundred bucks that 1 month from YouTube. Just a lucky, clickbait thumbnail got the job done. And I think that's when I realized, okay, you can actually make money off of making YouTube videos. I had never known that before. So months go by, then my channel got hit with a lot of copyright strikes. And I just deleted my channel. I deactivated it for a while. To my knowledge, it's actually still up. I think I re-logged into the Google account and you can still find it to this day, but there's no videos on there anymore. They've all been deleted. And I just kind of started over. I went from the name, that channel name was Steven No Sleep after my first name. And then it went from that to the channel that I have now, which is Mr. No Sleep OSRS. So I learned some important values and lessons from that old channel. Very short run, maybe a 6 month hobby, occasional videos, updates, etc. And that kind of set me up for, to not make the same mistake twice on the second channel. Good question though. Yeah, not many people remember that.
For the future of Mr. No Sleep's channel, after he kills every single monster in the game, how does he want to expand his content?
Well, right now, there's a thing that I've been trying out on my channel, which is a little questionable. I just started this week. It's actually different people. I've been friends with so many people on this game for almost a decade now. Very trusted friends, people I practically consider family. So there's been an idea recently, instead of me just making loot videos on my channel, maybe I recruit some of my closest friends, basically, almost brothers of mine, to do similar things, record their own videos, send it to me. I upload it. Everyone gets a cut. Everyone's happy. And that's what I've been doing. That's what I've been doing for about 2 weeks now. The uploads have tripled. It's incredible. Everyone's happy with it. Everyone's enjoying the results of it. Ideally, a one more year to a year and a half of the loot series would be great. And then after that, I think everything in game would have been covered and then maybe covered again. And then I would like to hopefully just play very casually, not stick with any particular series. And more so, just kind of either max my Iron Man out, start a hardcore, or maybe by this time there'll be group Iron Man, and that could be something that I look into. And you got to understand, when you do a video 2 years ago, people who can, Google that monster, YouTube that monster 10 years from then, in the future, that video will pop up. So it's a never-ending cycle of something getting rewatched, and I like that concept. I feel like if I do a daily event video where I kind of record my progress for a week and throw it up there, not many people would see it, years down the line. But if you do loot videos and you cover a certain specific thing in RuneScape, and people search for that thing, years down the line, your name will keep on popping up. And I love that concept of always being remembered, always having something out there. So it would be hard to replace the loot series. I honestly don't think I'd ever try. I would just be very casual and maybe just max in a couple accounts and maybe just do, basic, uploads. But that's a good question. I still don't have a complete answer on it, but that's my plan for now.
For many years, people on Reddit and the RuneScape community have been concerned for Mr. No Sleep's health. By doing 26 30-hour live streams, 5 50-hour live streams, 3 60-hour live streams, and even his 1 100-hour live stream, how has these streams affected his health?
There was a rumor going around for a long time that I was having heart trouble and all this stuff. And that's what happens on the internet. People can clip something on a stream and it can make you seem like you're in pain. But if you just tune in for 5 more minutes, you'll see that I completely, second wind comes and I'm, very lively, very wide awake again. So, no, I've never had any health complications. I've never gone to the hospital and said, I feel like I'm dying. It's all because of sleep deprivation. But no, I mean, I'm 22 years old. I've never been in good shape. I've always been, a little out of shape my whole life, but I've stayed up more than anyone on Twitch, anyone in any section. I'm not bragging about it. It's just a fact. I've done longer streams than anyone, and I feel great. I mean, I've never had a heart rate that was too high, too low. Even when I would do crazy things on stream in my younger days, just running around, just things like that, nothing crazy. I've never done drugs, never done uppers, only smoked medical weed my whole life. So there was never any, there was always rumors of cocaine, always rumors of just insane things that made no sense. And that's all it was rumors. But I will say the only thing that I have noticed after years of sleep deprivation, and honestly, it was really just the 100-hour live stream that tore, like, that really I could tell there was something different after that, and it's just memory loss. That's the only thing I have. Is it serious? Not so much, but it is noticeable. I will ask family members, people that I'm close with, the same question numerous times. Some people that I meet online, I'll ask them what their job is. They'll tell me it the next day. I have no idea. I have no memory. So that's one downside. I mean, it has its days where it's noticeable, and then most other days just go by, and it's just, I don't do too much to the point where I always notice it. But other than that, I've never had any pain, never had any drama come from it, minimal anyway. The only thing I can honestly say is just memory loss. That's it. So comes with it, unfortunately. It is a side effect.
Regarding his 100-hour stream, which is the longest RuneScape live stream on record, I want to know how he prepared for that and what made him stay up.
Woke up, I said, okay, I can do it. I was in a really weird place at the time. In real life, everyone has their days where they're just feeling like, something's going on. And I just said, you know what? I think today is the day to do it. So I just went for it. I had one cup of coffee at the very start of the stream, just black, and that was it. I had maybe 6 or 7 meals throughout the 100-hour. I didn't have any caffeine after the first day. I didn't have any Monster. I didn't have any sugar, nothing like that. The smartest thing for sleep deprivation that my psychology teacher told me many years ago was ice cold water. And I took his advice. So that's exactly what I did. I had ice cold water the whole entire live stream. Every 20 hours, I would shower. I was never away from my webcam for more than 10 minutes. I took that very seriously. I didn't want anyone to think I was sleeping, taking naps, or anything like that. I didn't have any help, no family members, nothing like that. No food was delivered. It was all just what was ever in the kitchen and what was ever available. That was what I had at my disposal. So, but no, there was no caffeine, no vaping, nothing like that. Just stretching, a lot of drinking water, the occasional meal every 10 hours. Most people know that when I stream, I don't like to eat anything. So the eating was very minimal, but it was doable. And the only way I got that stream done was Second Wind. It's more mental than it is physical. I'm not a doctor, but I can tell you from firsthand experience, you know, the thing that gets people to go to sleep is their brain telling them to go to sleep. It's literally your brain telling you, hey, it's, you know, I know you want to stay up, but screw it. It's not worth it. Well, it's you. It's up to you to tell your brain, no, it is worth it. You know, you can pretty much convince yourself and then unconvince yourself out of it. And it's just it's all manipulating your own brain. It's getting very strange at the end stages. You know, you're up for 60 hours, then 70, 80, 90. You're up for 90 hours straight. Then you have to say to yourself, I have to stay up another 10 hours. You know, you're up 70 hours straight. You have to say that you're going to stay up another 30. So it's just mental. It's you have to drive yourself almost crazy and then keep yourself sane. And I think that's why a lot of people think I'm a little out there, because, you know, sleep deprivation can do that if you do it a lot. Luckily, that was only a one-time thing, the long 100 hour. And what got me through it was just really insanity, was just, you know, making sure that you were crazy enough to complete it, crazy enough to keep on going no matter how tired you were, but also sane enough to, you know, at the same time be able to play RuneScape, train Slayer, and entertain the Twitch chat all at the same time and maintain composure.
My next question was, how long did he sleep after that stream? Because you were up for 100 hours? Surely you'd be sleeping for at least 2 days, but let's find out.
It's a very common question I get asked. It's just 11 hours. A lot of people don't know, but after that stream, I walked about a mile and a half. Because, you know, again, you're so disoriented. You're not telling yourself to go to sleep. Your adrenaline is so high at this point that you're capable of anything. You feel like you're invincible. So after that live stream, I walked to the ATM. I withdrew some money. And then I walked to a gas station. I got some ice cream with a friend of mine who was at the end of the stream, very end. He just came for the last hour. And we walked back to my apartment, and I fell asleep on my couch with the ice cream on my stomach, just, you know, sitting on my shirt, melted on me. And I fell asleep on my couch for 3 hours, woke up, went to my bed, fell asleep for 11 hours, woke up the next day. And for 3 days straight, I laid in bed. I didn't sleep. I wasn't tired. It wasn't like that at all. It's just your body is in the shock, because, you know, you really just go from being an average human to, you know, doing something that your body should never do, certainly never expects you to do. But little do people know, you know, the human body is just capable of a lot more than people give it credit for. So within 3 days of laying in bed, I was back to being normal. But to answer your question, it was just 11 hours followed by 3 days of just rest.
To wrap up this interview, Mr. No Sleep is getting close to 100,000 Twitch followers. Since he did loot from 100,000 goblins for 100,000 subscribers, I want to know if he has anything planned for 100,000 Twitch followers.
Most of the time, people are always curious about, like, at 200k YouTube subs, if I would do that, but I've never had a Twitch follower question. I don't know. I think most people would want another 100-hour live stream if they saw 100,000 followers. I know that would be the most commonly asked thing, but as it goes for another monster or something unique at 100,000 Twitch followers, I don't know. I don't think so. You know, the goblins it was manageable because all you had to do was bring a cannon and sit there, and that's it. But, you know, you're talking about, you know, 150, 200,000, because I certainly wouldn't want to do 100,000 again. So I don't know. I don't think so. I think there was an idea that I had at 150K YouTube subs to kill 150,000 Dark Wizards. And it was going to take a month and a half. So I looked at that and I said, wow, it's such a huge investment of time that it's just not realistic right now. So, I don't know. I do know that there'll be something. I'm always a man of my word as it goes for, you know, certain milestones. I always do something. So at least there'll be a 50-hour live stream, I'm sure. There'll be maybe a series going, but I doubt that it would be another 100,000 to 200,000 loot video, but it's not out of the question. I know it's going to happen one day. I just don't know if it would happen around that time.
And just like that, we got a rare insight to Mr. No Sleep. Let me know which content creator you want me to interview next. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like. If you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button. If you guys have any feedback, make sure to leave it down in the comments. All feedback is much appreciated. Anyways, my name is Snack Food, and I'll see you later. Peace.